Developing Our Math Minds is a series of conversations and resources about math that is intended to be a journey of growth for families over several weeks. Each week, Minds lead mathematician and product director Brandon Smith and content development manager Nina Wu will be talking about the adjustments families are making to learning at home and the opportunities this situation provides for changing our relationship with math.
Hey everyone, so I've been staring at the screen all day today and my eyes need a break. And one of my favorite things to do and easiest things to do is to take a walk. But we could mix it up. Instead of just any old walk, we can go for a math walk.
What's a math walk?
A math walk is just like your normal walk, but while you're outside, you also take notice of the math connections that you see in the world around you. Does that make sense? Great, let's go. Let me know when you see something. One thing you can do if you can't go very far is you could measure the distance from one point to another using different kinds of steps. Maybe if I go from this tree to that tree using one kind of step. One, two, three. And then I can measure in backward steps. 15, 16, 17. Why are forward steps and backward steps different? I think it's surprising that forward steps and backward steps are not equal. You'd think they'd be the same. Maybe how about sideways steps? 1, 2, 3. 14. We also do leaps. 1, 6, 6.5. So those are all different units of measurement for the same distance. I think another surprising thing is that the bigger the step, the fewer the steps it takes to measure something. Or the smaller the increment, the more it takes to measure the same distance. So I could take little steps around. This would be a lot more steps than those leaps. You can be creative about the different types of steps you take to measure a distance. Another thing you could do is look for different representations of the numbers 1 through 20 or 30 during the walk. And maybe your goal is to cross off each of those numbers. For example, this fire hydrant has 1, 2, 3, 4 spokes, so that could be number 4. So it'd be really easy to find all the numbers in the house numbers. That's a little bit cheating. I think we can do better than that. So here's a good example. I would say a 5. There's 5 petals on these flowers. What else can we find? My favorite thing to look at are plants. I think 4 is really easy to find. There's that rhombus, has 4 sides, it's a quadrilateral. Maybe another thing you could do is find a bunch of different types of quadrilaterals. Oh, look, that's also a nice example of an array, that rectangle. And you could probably count how many holes there are in that grate by counting the width and the length. 15 by 17, can't do that math in my head. Oh, and then this is a really nice fence. Fences are a really good example of a number line in real life. And so you could think of some math facts or do some math examples along a number line, like jumping backwards and jumping forwards along a number line. Or you could even count on this fence, like how often it peaks and dips. If you were to try to find all the different examples of numbers in the world around you, you might find certain numbers are way harder to find than others. Like, for example, like I would say 2, 3, and 4, and 5 might be really easy to find. But like 17 and other prime numbers might be harder to find because they might not exist in nature as naturally. I think this plant is really cool. You know what this plant reminds me of? It kind of reminds me of like probability trees or fractals, the way it kind of branches off one by one. This spoke has 2 branches coming off, and each one is symmetrical. It's 3 on each, it's symmetrical. And then this one branches out this way and has another 2 coming off, and there's 3 like little pom-poms on each. And then there has this one at the end. That's a cool example of like a probability or a fractal tree. There's a lot of estimation problems you could do, like estimating how many flowers are on a bush, for how tall a tree might be. This house has a lot of cool examples of geometry. Triangles and rhombuses and rectangles. You think about how different houses can be recreated with basic shapes. That trash can right there is a cool shape. It's a cool solid. It's like a rectangular prism with a trapezoidal prism on top. Those are some new shapes. What did you find? Ah, great find. Yeah, that stop sign is a really great representation of 8, for example. And I don't know if you've ever noticed, but different signs have different number of sides. For example, we have the yield sign, which is a triangle, 3 sides. I see speed bumps ahead over there is a 4-sided sign. And did you know, I've been told, that the more number of sides that a sign has, the more important of information it has. The stop sign with 8 sides is our most number-sided sign, meaning it has the most important information. It's really important for people to stop. Oh, and look, right behind it is a school crossing sign. Come on. School crossing sign has 5 sides, which is pretty important. It's probably a little more important than the 4-sided speed bumps ahead, also important.
Hold up. What about a circle? How many sides does that have? If it has no sides, then that would make it not important. But actually, circles might be the most important information because they have the most number of sides. If you think about it, a circle has infinitely many sides, and that's what makes it so smooth.
So yeah, it's a little factoid and a good math connection. Oh, it also says traffic fines doubled. That's a good math connection. I could ask you all sorts of questions. If the fine were $72, what would that be doubled? You can ask a lot of doubling questions. Okay. So, there's also many different types of symmetry in plants. And so like, these little flowers right here, they have like radial symmetry. And same with these succulents. And then there's also plants with reflective symmetry. This fern guy over here. And ferns are also a really great example of fractals, meaning they kind of branch and branch and branch and keep going. It's a really great example of multiplication and like exponential growth. And so if you wanted to count like the little fronds on the plant, you could count one side and then double it because they have reflective symmetry. Good, another good find. That's a really great example of a triangle. And what's even more specific and cool about it is that it's an isosceles triangle because it has these 2 equal sides. This kind of makes me think about another thing you could do is do some shadow play and what shapes can you make with your silhouette of the shadow with the changing angle of sun that might be setting behind you. That was just 2 blocks of a math walk, and even in that short 2 blocks, we found so many connections, and the longer you walk, the more connections you'll find, because math is all around us. It's also a great way to get out of the house and take a break from staring at the screen all day, and make more connections and bring life to math and also to your day-to-day life. Enjoy it. I can't wait to see all the things that you find in the world around you.